Hey, what's up, Bully fam? Chris here, signing in once again for Phil and Bully Camp. And today, our topic is 5 things to consider when you're breeding American bullies and produce show puppies. I just came from the vet to confirm FBC Sweet Jazzy, my female dog, that she's gonna have puppies. And the vet told me that she will have 8 puppies minimum. Right there, she's sleeping. And if you wanna see her belly right there, Jazzy, okay, she's taking a rest. Alrighty, and she was bred to my stud. His name is BMB Boris the Spider, and I'm gonna tell you why I did this breeding. Please watch through the end of the video so that this is an important topic and you're gonna learn a lot from this video. Let's go. Today I'm driving to George Bailey to help me with the breeding of BMB Boris the Spider and FBC Sweet Jazzy. Yes, Sweet Jazzy got her heat and she's ready now. So we will be doing AI on her and the stud will be BMB Boris the Spider. Hope it takes and let's pray about it. Okay, see you later. What's up, Bully fam? This is the 3rd day breeding of my breeding with BMB Boris the Spider and FBC Sweet Jazzy. I traveled like 150 miles just for this breeding. Back to back, it would be like 300 miles. Because we spent a lot of time doing this breeding and it's not easy. I cannot do it myself, so I'm asking for the help of Mr. George Bailey. Going to Lakeland, Florida now. What's up, Bully fam? This is the third day session of the breeding of Boris and FBC Sweet Jazzy. I hope this breeding will be successful and keep in touch. What's up, Bully fam? Can you see Boris there sleeping? Boris the Spider sleeping well. Boris, Jazzy on my back here. Jazzy, hope you can see her. This is the 3rd day of breeding. In this episode, I'm gonna infuse also or show you how Jazzy was bred to Boris, the struggles in breeding, how I did it, and so that you learn something about breeding American bullies. And the importance of progesterone testing so that you'll hit the peak level of the fertility rate of the female. And I did it every other day. Those stuff like the development of the female, my observations like from 30 days, if she swelled up, her eating habits, I took pictures and videos while she's growing up to the she's in 44th day now. So I took some pictures and videos so that you'll see the development and you'll know that if your female dog took the breeding. Okay? Number one in my list is your female or the bitch that you're gonna use in the breeding should meet the standards that you need. Your vision, she should meet your vision or the structure that the puppies will get when they grow up. That means that they will have the structure, the movement, the temperament. Those are the things that you want for the puppies to have when they go out, when they grow up. So the reason why I chose Jazzy is that my female dog is because she got that good structure, she got that temperament, and she got good movement. So why did I say that? And I'm not being biased to my dog because she's like this, she's like that. But you know what? What I did, I really don't go to ABKC shows. So what I did is to prove that what I'm seeing is not bias. I joined one ABKC show with her when she was younger. So I'm gonna put a clip on this, and you know what? We got first place in her first show outing. So that means she got it. So without thinking, I bred her because I know that when she produces puppies, these puppies will be like her. But I want to improve the bone structure in this litter. So I know that the stud that I'm gonna use is Boris. He got big bone, and his grandfather and his bloodline is from Magu. Magu was sold to China for a certain large amount of money. So I know that Boris is a tool to give the bone to the puppies that Jassy will have. And so that's number one. The female bitch should have the structure and the vision that you want for the puppies to have. And always think of this. The puppies will get more traits and characteristics from the mom or the bitch. Like, it will be like 70 to 80%. So always remember that. The puppies always get their traits and physical structures from the mom. So if you're gonna use a subpar female dog for your breeding, or that lacks breed type of an American bully, don't do this. Don't do it, because you're just gonna waste time and the puppies won't meet the breed standards of ABKC. All right? Number two in my list is bone. An American bully must have that bone structure to get what the judges are looking for, and they call it the breed type. They should have that mass, girth, and bone in their body. So you can get that if you have a bitch or a female that you're gonna breed and it's got its bone, that will be better. But if your female dog doesn't have that much bone, use a stud or an American bully stud that's got the bone, so that he can be a tool or complement, or like as they say, share the bone to the puppies, and the puppies can get it. So if your stud throws his if the stud throws his looks on the puppies, and that's a good thing, because the puppies will have the bone, and if the mom got good structure, so it will be bone and structure, and that will complement each other. And then when the puppies grow up, they will have that bone and structure that they can use in the dog shows. Please, if your bitch and the studs that you're gonna using is subpar, it's hard, because you're gonna do the breeding, you're gonna spend money, you're gonna waste the money, because these puppies that they will produce will be like pit bulls, or and they won't meet the breed type that the judges that will be looking for in that dog or puppy. So again, in this top, in for number two, bone is important. You can get that through your stud, or if your bitch got that bone already, so then that's good, because stud with the bone and female with the bone, of course the puppies will have bone. But if your female is not that boned up, get a stud that is boned up so that, and the stud will throw his bones to those puppies, and the mama's good structure, then game over. Okay, number three in my list, it's really important for me, because I have already Jassy, and Jassy is white in color, but she has a black spot near his tail. It's kind of big, so I don't worry about that, because I know she can throw some color in it, and I have proven that in her first breeding. She didn't produce any white dogs. I'm not against white dogs, but some people, they stay away from white because they don't like it. They just don't like it because it's a dominant color and they don't win much in shows. But for me, as long as the dog has structure and bone, that white color won't be seen. People won't see that. The judge won't see that. Okay, so number three for me is color. And you know why? Why I use Boris on Jassy? Because Boris, in his ancestors, in his pedigree, his ancestors are tricolor carriers. So I'm going to try to infuse that color from Boris to be shared to the puppies from Jassy. And let's see what will happen. Okay, so number three for me is color. Because the judges also look, because it's like a rainbow. If you paint a rainbow with black and white and not no color, it's dull, right? But if you draw a rainbow with color, the different colors in it, paint it with different colors, it will be so beautiful. It's just like with the dog. The more color it has, and the more they will be attractive. That's number three on the list. Okay, number four on the list for me is movement. Yeah, movement. American bully should be able to move gracefully and swiftly when they're gating with their rear angulations, like a bicycle, you know. They move like that, straight. They don't throw like that when they walk. It's ugly. So when dogs move, the rear leg should not be throwing out, and the front arm should be straight too, like a robot. So that's number one too, movement. Dogs that move gracefully in the show ring, they will win 100%. And make sure when you train them, you stride with them gracefully too, so that the timing is important too when you gate your dog. So practice makes perfect though. Always gate with the dog when you're in training. Do circles around the ring, make a temporary ring in your area, and gate with him. Like, because sometimes the dog is has smaller steps than you, then you should slow down a little bit. But if the dog has bigger steps than you, you should catch up with this movement. Keep on practicing the gait so that you will be synchronized with your dog when you're gating. Because the dog looks at the judge look at it. And it's important. That's one of the criteria they look for, the movement. Okay? So that's why when you watch dog shows, they let the dogs run up and down the ring, circle around the ring. When they're ready to finalize which dog they chose, and it's a tight competition, they even let the dogs walk or gate down, up and down again for the final decision. So movement is important for me. For the last one, the number five in the list for me to That's important when you're breeding American bullies. It's ignored, but for me this is very important. The temperament. Temperament means it's the attitude, it's like the attitude of the dog towards people and other dogs. So if your dog is vicious, like the female, she growls on other dogs when she's mad or something, and she growls at other people. For me, that's a no-no for me, because that trait will be passed to the puppies. So make sure when you breed American bullies, your dog should be well-balanced, should have a well-balanced attitude. And even though you don't socialize them, they will be so friendly. Why? Because it's in their genes. So if you're gonna use a female bitch and a stud that keeps on barking at other people and lounges at strangers and keep on barking, that they wanna bite the stranger again, and if they're like so playful, they don't follow the master, the owner, again, please include that in your list, that if you're gonna breed an American bully, make sure the dog is well balanced attitude. You know what I'm saying, like they're not vicious, they're so friendly, but they bark to strangers, they bark when the owner tells them to stop, they stop. They have to be controlled dogs. So, and a controlled dog is a happy owner. So if you don't train, even though you don't train your dogs and your dogs have a well-behaved temperament, that's a good thing, because it comes from their genetics and it can be passed to the puppy. So make sure when you use a female bitch and a stud in the breeding, make sure they have a well-balanced attitude. Okay, I guess you've learned a lot from this episode. Okay? Dali! Jesse, you okay? Good? Huh? Good? What's up, guys? I'm back. As of now, Jesse's in their like 46th day of pregnancy, and what I'm doing now is supporting her with the development of the puppies inside her by giving her vitamins rich in calcium and folic acid. Calcium is to prevent eclampsia, wherein it's like a calcium deficiency and gives the puppies more bones in the development of their bones. And the eclampsia is to support Jesse so that she won't be deficient in calcium. While folic acid helps with the development of the puppies inside her womb. Okay? Make sure you give vitamins to your dogs when they're pregnant, because they need it more to enhance the appetite. Because sometimes in the 38th day, the puppies are developing and it's like a pregnant person, you know, in human. They lose their appetite and they have morning sickness and something like that. So they need vitamins to support their body while the puppies are developing. These are the important stages. So early signs of pregnancy, give them vitamins. Once you confirmed it with the ultrasound, after 30 days, give them vitamins. Okay, and I hope you learned something from this episode. Breeding American Bullies is not cheap. You have to do progesterone testing. You have to do C-section. You have to whelp the puppies. It's endless whelping of the puppies. Make sure they're in good temperature. You know those stuff, simple things, but that means a lot with the puppies because they cannot talk and speak to us, so they need our help. Please do like, share, and subscribe our Philembolicam channel, and so that you will get notified with all the videos that I will upload. And I would really appreciate it. It's only free. Click on the link down below. Subscribe. Okay, hope all is well with you and the family, and thank you, and God bless. Bye.